2. People with special needs. Exercise time. 1. Tick the correct answer. Here we have few sentences which are incomplete. We have to complete these sentences by choosing the correct answer from the given options. Here there are 4 options. We have to choose the correct answer from these given options. 1. Old members are an important part of a dash. So here the options are A. Family, B. School, C. Park, D. Office. The correct answer here is family. Old members are an important part of a family. So we will put a tick mark here for the family, which is an A option. 2. 1st October is celebrated as. The options here are A. Gandhi Jayanti, B. Hearing Aids Day, C. Old Age Day, D. None of these. Here the correct answer is Old Age Day. We will put a tick mark for the option C here. 3. Braille was developed by dash. A. Louis Braille, B. John Milton, C. Ludwig van Beethoven, D. Helen Keller. So here the correct answer for this is Louis Braille. Braille was developed by Louis Braille. We will put the tick mark for option A. 4. People who cannot hear and talk at all use dash. The options here are Braille, B. Sign language, C. Both A and B, D. None of these. Here the correct answer is people who cannot hear and talk at all use sign language. This is the correct answer. We will put a tick mark for the option B. So this is the first bit of tick the correct answer. Now we will move to the next bit. Two. Match the following. Here we have two columns, column A and column B. We have to match the column A words with that of column B. What are the words here? Braille script, 1st October, 15th October, eyes, ears. And in this column we have white cane day, organs of sight, organs of hearing, old age day, Louis Braille. So the first one here is Braille script. What does the Braille script mean? What is it? It is a script for blind people. So here we can match Braille script with Louis Braille because Braille script was developed by Louis Braille. 2. 1st October. What is 1st October? It is the Old Age Day. It is celebrated as Old Age Day. We will match the 1st October with Old Age Day. 3. 15th October. 15th October is celebrated as White Cane Day. We will match the 15th October with White Cane Day. 4. Eyes. What are eyes? Those are organs of sight. We will match eyes with organs of sight. 5. Ears. Ears are organs of hearing. We will match ears with organs of hearing. 6. About the match the following, which is the second bit. Now we will move to the next bit. 3. Fill in the blanks with the words given in the box. In this box there are some words given. We have to fill these blanks with the help of given words to make a correct sentence. What are the words here? Soft, digest, resting, old age homes, deaf, braille script. These are the words. We have to use these words and fill in the blanks. What are the sentences here? 1. Old people should be given food that is dash and easy to dash. So the words here are soft and easy to digest. Now let's read the sentence. Old people should be given food that is soft and easy to digest. 2. We should not make noise when old people are dash. So resting can be the correct answer here. We should not make noise when old people are resting. 3. Dash was developed by Louis Braille. Here the answer is Braille script. Now let's read the sentence. Braille script was developed by Louis Braille. 4. Some old people live in dash. Here the answer is old age homes. Some old people live in old age homes. The 5th one. Some people who cannot hear at all are called dash. The answer here is deaf. Some people who cannot hear at all are called deaf. So this is about the 3rd bit. Now we will move to the next bit. Tick the true and cross the false statements. Here we have 4 statements. Among these, some are true statements and some are false statements. We have to identify them and put the cross and the tick marks. 1. We can express our feeling with our ears. This is a false statement, so we will put the cross mark. 2. Old people do not need love and support. This is a false statement, so we will put a cross mark. Some people who cannot hear at all are called blind. This is also a false statement because people who cannot hear are called deaf. So this is a false statement. We will put a cross mark here. Blind people are those who cannot see. 4. We should not be cruel to physically challenged people. Yes, this is a true statement. We will put a tick mark here. 5. Answer the following questions. Here we have few questions. We have to read the question and write the answer. First question is, what is Braille script? Now the answer is, the script on which the blind people move their fingers to feel different patterns of raised dots to read is called Braille. 2. Who are physically challenged people? Now the answer is, people who cannot see, hear or speak are called physically challenged people. 3rd question is, why do some people wear spectacles? Now the answer here is, when eyesight becomes weak, people wear spectacles. So these are the 3 questions. Now we will move to the next question. Question number 4. How can we help old people? The answer is, we can help old people to climb stairs, offer them seat in a bus, fill a glass of water, give them a gift on their birthday and not making noise when they are resting. This is the answer. Now the 5th question is, What is a hearing aid? The answer here is, hearing aid is a small instrument worn in the ear which amplifies the sound and allows the person to hear more clearly. So these are the questions and answers which you can write in your workbook. The next section is HOTS. The next section under exercise time is HOTS. Why do physically challenged people need encouragement? So can you tell me, children, why do physically challenged people need encouragement? You can write like this. Physically challenged people do not require any type of sympathy but require encouragement that they can perform all the work which a normal person can do. We should give them motivation and confidence that they can handle all work easily. So children, physically challenged people do not require sympathy, but they require encouragement that they can perform all the work which a normal person can do. And we should give them motivation and confidence that they can do all work easily. And this is about the HOT section. Now we will move to the next section. The next section here is value-based questions. And A, what should we do for needy or old people? So what should you do for needy or old people, children? Let's read. We should give groceries to needy people who cannot even afford a meal for themselves or their family. We should not waste food. Some things which we do not need may be an essential and needful item, so we should give them those things. And we should respect and help old people by spending time with them and listening to them. We should be polite and ask them for advice. We should try to eat together and discuss family heritage, history and traditions. Children, we should help the needy people by giving them groceries. And also we should not waste food because some people, they don't have anything to eat. And sometimes some people waste food by throwing them. So we should not throw food and give it to the needy people. And for old people, we should try to spend time with them and listen to them. We should be polite and ask them for advice. We should try to eat together with the old people and discuss family heritage, history and traditions. Now the B question under value based questions is, how can we show our love for physically challenged people? We should be respectful in our words and actions when speaking to a disabled person. We should speak clearly, listen well and speak directly to disabled people. We should ask before providing assistance to them and show love and care to disabled person. We should be patient, polite and courteous to them. So how can we show love to physically challenged people? We should be respectful in our words and actions when speaking to a disabled person. And we should speak clearly, listen to them and speak directly to them. We should ask before providing any assistance to them and show love and care to disabled person. We should be patient, polite and courteous to physically challenged people. And this is about the value-based questions and their exercise time. Home assignment / project. Collect and paste the pictures of Indian gold, silver and bronze medal winners of Rio Paralympics 2016. Write names below pictures. Children, in this activity you have to collect the pictures of medal winners of Rio Paralympics 2016. You collect the pictures of people who have won gold, silver and bronze medals in Rio Paralympics 2016 and write the names below the pictures. So collect the pictures of these people and paste in the space provided in your workbook. So after pasting the pictures, write the names below the pictures, the name of the person and the medal winner. Write the first gold medal winner, paste the picture here, then write the name here. Then paste silver medal winner picture here, then write the name of the person below the picture. Then paste the picture of the bronze medal winner, then write the name below picture. On top you write gold, silver medal, bronze medal. Gold medal, silver medal, bronze medal. Then paste the picture. Then write the name below the picture. So this is the activity under home assignment/project.